Hello there, this is Lynn Allen. Thank you so much for joining me for another AutoCAD tip courtesy of the fabulous Cadalyst magazine. I hope you're having a great week so far. I've had a great week. I'm coming to you from Washington, D.C. Yes, yet another hotel room where I just finished attending the amazing Revit Technology Conference. Okay, but we're focusing on AutoCAD today. Now, the tip that I'm going to share with you will come in handy for any of you who do baseline or continued dimensions. Just about all of you, pretty much. Or if you don't do those dimensions, I want to know how. How do you get away with not having to do them? But anyway, so I'm going to come in here and I want to add in a continued dimension to this existing one. So I will select this dimension. I'm lazy. So I'm just going to use the grips, which I talked about on another tip, to add in a continued dimension. And as I move my cursor up here and I select, and I'm like looking at the screen and I'm like, wait a minute. This dimension looks completely different from the baseline dimension. That's because it's in a different dimension style because I forgot to change my current dimension style before I added on that continued dimension. All right, but then you might want to ask yourself, is there ever a time when you're doing baseline dimensions or continued dimensions that you don't want to use the exact same dimension style as the base dimension? No. Well, okay, not in my experience. Not when I was teaching school. So, in an effort to not terribly upset my drafting teacher, I would erase it and fix it, right? So I will erase it. Well, it seems kind of stupid that I have to even worry about that. So when 2014, AutoCAD 2014 came out, they added in a system variable called DimContinueMode. And when that value is set to 1, I don't ever have to think about what my dimension style is for the base dimension. Whenever I do continued or baseline dimensioning, it will just duplicate and use the same style as the base dimension. I love that. I'm lazy. I've told you so many times I'm a lazy AutoCAD operator. I don't want to have to ever think about this, right? So let's try this again. So I set dim continue mode to 1, which incidentally is the default, but I know some people, set everything back after they upgrade to a new release of AutoCAD. So hopefully you didn't do that. So now let's see what happens. Now I'm going to do a continued dimension. And look, see, it knows to use the exact same dimension style as the original one. All right, now it doesn't change the current dimension style. That will go back to whatever it was before. It only changes it for that continued or that baseline dimension that you happen to be doing. But I love that. I don't even have to think about it. That's a fabulous thing. So if you have AutoCAD 2014 or higher, make sure that you have Dim Continue mode set to 1. And you can be a lazy AutoCAD operator like me. Get your jobs done faster and not have to worry about always resetting your current dimension style. Yay! I hope you have a great rest of the week, and I'll see you back here in 2 more weeks. Thank you so much for joining me.